Hello, everybody. This is another series of AIOps Explained. Today, we want to talk you through our capabilities within the Cloud Pak for Watson AIOps regarding log anomaly detection. And with that, I have a guest in here, which is in the IBM Silicon Valley Labs. He's a senior data scientist. It's Xiaotong. Please introduce yourself.
Hi, everyone. This is Xiaotong from SVL. I'm a senior data science and manager from IBM Automation. Glad to meet you guys.
Thank you. I'm Fred Klein. I'm located in Berlin. You already know me. I talked you through all these nice videos. I hope they are nice. And let's start with this one. Go ahead, please, into the agenda. Today, we are talking you through a few slides. We want to introduce what is log anomaly detection using Cloud Pak for Watson AIOps. We do have natural language processing capabilities in here. We talk through what is training, the feedback loop, data ingestion possibilities. We do have a link into the documentation also. And at the end of the video, we are going to show you what it is in a demo. And just to briefly set the scene, the Cloud Pak for Watson AIOps takes a multitude of operational data ingestions. So for example, you can ingest event data, metric data, topology data coming from CMDB. You can have incidents via trouble ticketing systems and so on and so on and so on. So quite a number of ingestion capabilities in here. They are divided into structured data and unstructured data. And as you can see here on the left of the graphics, these are the ingestion channels. And they are going then into the individual capabilities. We do start with individual processing capabilities, like the event processing capability in here. There's correlation engine, enrichment causation engine. There's the log processing engine, which we're talking today, metric processing, and so on and so on. Then we do have the central capabilities for Watson AIOps, and we do have the UIs here on the right side. There are also a number of application programmable interfaces, APIs available, as we do have a number of out-of-the-box integrations. So this is the overall setup of our solution. And if you do one more click, yeah, this is what we're talking today. So this is logs, log processing, and detecting anomalies within these logs streaming into the system.
Okay, a bit background. So logs are one of the key sources of the data generated by our IT systems, including like business applications, infrastructure system, and the networking system, and so on. So these logs are generally produced in different formats in many different locations. And logs are very useful for detecting and diagnosing problems, as well as providing explanations for problems. Right now, Watson AIOps provides AI capabilities that can automatically detect anomalies from logs. So it will greatly reduce the time for SREs to detect problems without having to consistently monitor and analyze logs for each individual log sources. And speaking of log sources, so right now we support the different log data ingestions, including customized connector, Elk, Homeo, Kafka, LogDNA, and Splunk. So the main benefit of it is once you connect these sources in AIOps using these different connector mappings, users don't have to worry about, you know, which logs are coming from which source. AIOps can monitor all of these at the same time. SREs don't actually have to switch back and forth to different, you know, log managing tools, and they can all be done in AIOps.
And so just one ingestion, it can be multiple simultaneously, isn't it?
Yeah. So you can set up multiple connectors even for one ingestions, and you can link to different applications. Let's say you have one simulations for, you mean, selling your socks, the other application for monitoring, you know, your system logs. You can have different connectors running at the same times. And in our pipeline, if we want to train, you know, models that can work for all these connectors, you can just do one version of training and models will take care of all of these different data sources.
Pretty cool. Within Metric Manager, in the former version, we had a constraint that these time series data needed to be time aligned. So they needed to be in the same timing. Is that something we do have to care of here in log management as well?
We have two, can say, pipelines. One is a training and the other is like inference. So in training, we don't actually care about time. So you can have unsorted data. But in the inference, we actually try to use these models to do the detection. We do require the data to be sorted because we are actually monitoring this system behavior over time, right? So otherwise, we'll have some data lost because when we ingest data, when we close the windows, we will lose the data in the past. So if this data is coming in out of order, so you could have some data lost.
Cool.
Okay, so I will talk a bit about the detection capabilities in AIOps and show some examples of different types of log anomalies. So first we have this natural language log anomaly detection, which consists of offline training and runtime inference pipelines. The offline training pipeline includes log parsing, embedding extraction, and detection model training. So essentially we learn different representations of logs and their distributions, also known as feature vectors, during normal periods, and we train machine learning model to capture all this information. So to model the system behavior over time, we group the log messages of every 10-second time window based on the logging time step and average these feature vectors of logs within each time window to form the feature vector. So the runtime inference pipeline checks if an anomaly occurs for a given time window during runtime. It will detect an anomaly if the feature vector of a new time window is significantly different from the normal representations we learned in our trained models. And recently, we introduced real-time statistical models and the WebSphere out-of-the-box models for anomaly detection. The main difference of these new models to the natural language models is that it can provide insights immediately without offline training. The real-time statistical models uses information from our entity extraction, such as error conditions, to look for anomalies. The good thing about this model is that it only requires 30 minutes of data to learn a baseline, and it will be updated in real time as more data are available. The WebSphere out-of-the-box models uses a domain-specific knowledge to pre-train a model that can detect anomalies in WebSphere logs out of the box. Now let's look at some examples of different types of log anomalies. In the first examples, given that our natural language models can extract different log patterns, if regular patterns occur unexpectedly more times than normal, we will predict it as an anomaly. Or if we start to see some unknown patterns that we had never seen before, it could also be an anomaly. In the next example, when we look at these error signals from logs, for instance, if we see 500 errors and their frequency is significantly higher, it would be a good indicator of something abnormal. And similarly, an anomaly would be identified when we start to see more logs that contain exceptions. And when we look at the WebSphere logs, since we have domain-specific knowledge about message ID and log levels, if we observe a lot of more error message ID or error log levels, we can identify anomalies in these WebSphere logs. And next, I'll present a demo of how we can observe and understand anomalies in our chat hubs. In this demo, we ingest different files into different components of a few applications AIOps is monitoring. We start to see stories being created with different log anomaly alerts in chat hubs. The first alert is from a component of SOC Shop application. Here we use our entity extraction to understand that the number 500 was an HTTP 500 status code, and the alert was detected out by our real-time statistical model as the actual count of the 500 error is very different from what we would expect. We can also see the corresponding logs containing such 500 errors. The second alert indicates issues also from SOC shop application. So this seems similar to the last one, but in addition to error codes, our entity extraction also identifies exceptions. Here again, we can see that attributions of exceptions is quite different from our expectation. What's convenient here is you can directly see these exception logs in our Slack without having to switch back to other, you know, log tools. Okay, the next one is detected from web sphere logs. The actual count of the log level is significantly different from the expected one. So checking the corresponding raw logs, looks like some LDAP failure is happening. This LDAP failure caused some specific error message ID or log level being raised in web sphere logs. Again, the SRE doesn't have to go dig them out as we have automatically surfaced them. Today, we just do this for WebSphere, but we are working on adding other domains as well. Let's see what we have in the next one. We see an alert raised from a component in the QOTD application. Here we see this log pattern with unexpectedly high frequency than was considered as normal. And it's being detected by our natural language log anomaly detection model. This is a case where the SRE would not have been able to figure out that while they're seeing the known logs, the frequency or distribution of them is abnormal. This hidden pattern helps them pinpoint which components to focus on. The last alert we're seeing here is also from the QOTD application, but from a different component. Looks like we see some unexpected templates or log patterns. This means we're getting some logs which never seen when the system was running normally, but they start to appear when the problem happened. This is a type of information an SRE looks for when trying to pinpoint where to focus.
Thank you. That was really an insightful demonstration of the capabilities. And here on this slide, you can see we do have, of course, documentation. So here's the link to the documentation, as well as you can see a starting screenshot of those. So there's lots and lots of stuff to discover in here. And I think that's almost it, isn't it?
Yeah. Thank you guys for your attention.
Cool. Thank you all for being here, spending your time with us. And I hope you enjoyed it. And see you another time in another video. Bye.
Bye.